going on, YouTube? This is Mitch Santone. I'm here with a video review. This one is for Jetpack Bumblebee, also known as Hydro Dive or Hydro Drive, I think, Bumblebee in the States. However, this is a Takara version, which is not going to be released here as Jetpack Bumblebee, at least as far as I know. And I just figured I'd show them off in the package because the package is beautiful and I'm about to tear it open and just null and void this beautiful little packaging here. So as you can see, Bumblebee comes packed in his robot mode. You can see he's very gold, almost gold bug-ish. And he's got his crazy looking jetpack here with some thrusters. Let's see what we say here. Autobot Speedster. This is the Speedster of the Autobots, in case you didn't know that. And of course on the back there's a story which I can't read. And his gimmick. His gimmick is Transform, which is cool. His weapon is that, along with that face. That's his face. That's correct. Transform, yeah, again, right back at ya. And nice little artwork here of Hydro Dive, or I'm sorry, Jet. What is this guy called? Something Bumblebee. You get the picture. But I'm going to get this guy open. I'm probably going to get another one of these things just to leave in the box because I do like these. I do like the Takara boxes. I think they're quite nice, actually. So that's that. I will get this guy ripped open and we'll get on with this review. Okay, so I got Bumblebee depackaged. And here he is. I actually transformed him into his alt mode, which is his little fanzone car. Okay, it's decent. It looks a little bit more squat than his other it looks even more cartoony than the original one, I think. And you know, for comparison, I'm gonna grab the original. I don't know why I didn't do it, but I'm gonna get it right now. Okay, so excuse me. This is the regular deluxe. Let me move his jet thing. We'll get to that in a second. This is the regular deluxe with side by side with the other one. This is the activator. So he's about between size wise between the activator and the deluxe class. Do this just to give you a little size shot of these guys. But I think he is more in scale with the rest of the line. And I'm going to do a little lineup shot when I'm done with all of this. But I want to kind of plow through this. I'm not going to go too nutty on the tech specs because I want to kind of talk about and do some comparisons and such. Character, I gave him a 6. Animated Bumblebee, he's alright. He's obviously aimed at the kiddies, not really aimed at me. He had some cool stuff that he did do and some really annoying stuff that he did do too. So, but mold on this guy is an 8. I like this. It's a little bit different than what we're used to here, a little bit squat in this mode and not as much detail as the other one. I think it pulls it off though, and I like it. And this is pretty cool too. Comes with this little, well, this giant jetpack deal, which is pretty cool. And this can be added to him in both modes, and I'm gonna put them together, but I'm gonna cut this for time. Okay, so you plug him into the back, and what's cool is you can keep him. You can keep this jetpack on him. This whole black tray here pegs into his back, and it stays there. It can stay there in both modes. So you can basically flip this top part up. Right now, you can see it's he's in his vehicle mode, whatever this is. It's a underwater something or another. This thing pulls up, and then you can kind of like I say, it swivels around. You can spin this around, so you can spin them back out of here, and it just fell off. Okay, scratch that. But anyway, if he was pegged in a little bit tighter, you can flip him around, then you can transform Bumblebee, and then you can flip this thing over his shoulders, which I'm going to do next. Okay, so back to the tech spec. I got him transformed. I gave this guy a 8 in mold, and I thought it's cool. I think it's very cool. I think it's cool with his jetpack. Going on, paint, I give this guy about a 5 because he didn't look bad in, well, first of all, he's gold, right? He's just shiny gold at that, which really isn't Bumblebee color. Bumblebee's yellow, like a bright lemon yellow. So, it right off the bat, it's kind of a knock against him because I like when people, well, I like when the figures are character or like cartoon accurate. So, He's gold, but what kind of really sucks is that, and my camera is not doing a very good job of picking this up at all. He actually looks like he blends in more in my view screen than he does in real life. The gold is nice, even though it's not accurate. I like the gold. I think it's very nice. Except this is like a Dijon mustard brown, and it does not match at all. It looks, like I say, it looks, you gotta trust me on this, that it looks way better on camera than it does in holding it in my hand. It doesn't match, and it looks kind of crummy. So the paint on this guy, I gotta give a 5-2. I'm not a real big fan of that color at all. And I'm dying for the Hasbro version now because I want yellow, and I want this guy in yellow. And if I ever pick another guy up and I can find a good customizer because I suck at it, I will have him paint me a yellow one. Anyway, alt mode on this guy. He's obviously out of alt mode. I gave this dude a 7 by himself, but an 8 with his jetpack because I thought that was cooler. This transformation though is I give a 9 to. It's very simple in the head and stuff, but little cool bits go on here. He's got a faux hood just like his deluxe version did. The way these transform is very neat. It's actually very neat. It looks like it just pulls up and out and doesn't. It spins then turns and then it kind of sweeps itself back and forms his foot. It's really cool. And it's cool that you can keep all this stuff together too. On him, if you choose to do that, and never take the jetpack off if you want. So I did like that too. That bit of engineering I can definitely appreciate because I'm sure it was no easy feat. So transformation, give a 9-2. It's pretty solid. This robot mode, I get a 9-2-2. I like this. I think he looks a little bit better proportioned than the deluxe class. And I'm gonna transform the deluxe class and the activator, and we'll do a little comparison. I'm probably going to do a little bit of a group shot with the whole animated lineup and probably use him in place of this guy. Probably the Supreme class or the Leader class bulkhead. Probably with the Wingblade Voyager that I just picked up as well, and which I'll be reviewing next. And this guy, even though he's gold, and I just to represent him and obviously the Samurai Prowl. And that's it. So let me get his armor on him. The robot mode, I give a 9. Articulation, I give a 7-2. He's pretty decent. He's got a lot of good leg poseability. His arms are hindered a little bit, just kind of like the same as this guy. He's actually got a little bit more side to side than this guy does. Nothing at the hands at all. Head's on a ball, can look up and down, but he can't really tilt side to side too much. Kind of hindered by the weird looking face on him. The head sculpt, I should say. But not too bad. Not too bad. Let me get these guys out of the way here, and we'll get the armor on him in his robot mode and see what that looks like. Okay, jetpack on. And we flip his little hood thingy down. And now he can. Look at that. That's a little automorph. It jams his hands down into the place of putting the guns in them. I'm not going to do it. You can put the guns in his hands if you really want to fiddle. I'm just going to pretend like they're in his hands. But yeah, he walks around. He's a little freaking mech looking, doing whatever on this. And I assume with this aquatic thrust looking stuff, this is in the ocean, yeah, something like that, or flying, I guess. I don't know. It's Jetpack Bumblebee, so obviously this is either a flyer or I always thought this looked more like a little bit of a scuba thing. I guess just with that blue and the fact that the other one was called Hydro Dive or Hydro Drive. But that's that. Pretty cool. Pretty cool figure. I'm very happy to have this. This is the last new mold that Animated is coming out with that we know of. So kind of sad that it's gone. I'm hoping that it won't be the last one. I'm hoping if these sell well enough over in Japan that they continue the line and maybe every now and then throw us a little, I don't know, Wheeljack, maybe Perceptor. I don't know, a couple guys that never made it in there. Oh gosh, the Constructicons. That would suck, huh? Now, anyway, quality control on this guy, though, I'm going to do real quick. I give it a 5 because, well, he doesn't tab together real well in his alt mode. And these things are meant to come off and stick in his doors. They don't. Not at all. Not on my figure, at least. They do not at all. I tried every possibility of getting these things in there, and they do not do it. And it kind of sucks because it looks cool when he's got his thrusters. It kind of helps his alt mode out a little bit. But they don't work. They do not stick in there. So, ouch on that. So, yeah, his alt mode, he's got some flaws with. But the rest of it looks decent and it works rather well. So, just that one thing was kind of major for me because I wanted to see what this guy looked like with thrusters on. And you can't use the other thrusters either because these are square pegs and these are round ones on the Lux over here. So, overall rating on this guy, I give a 7.2. I would say that if he was yellow, if he was this color, I'd probably go about an 8. Because I'd probably like this guy a lot better if he was accurate colors. I don't dislike the gold, but I do dislike that mustard brown a lot. I think he would look cool if he was just all in that gold. But I think that is really huge to my liking of this figure. It's pretty gimmicky. Yeah, I don't mind it though that much. It's pretty unique. I mean, I got to imagine this was written into season 4 at some point. I mean, I don't know why they would just come up with this getup, you know? Just a new mold for Bumblebee and then this. So I don't know. I don't get it. But I'll take it, man. I'll take as much animated as they'll give me. So I give it a 7. I don't know if it's worth the money that it costs to have imported right now. If it comes out in the States, though, I'd say pick it up. But I would definitely wait for it to become yellow again. So this is Mitch Santona, and this is Hydro Drive Bumblebee. Stay tuned because I've got Wingblade Optimus coming right up.